The single malt whiskey is taking not only Singapore but Asia by storm. It started in Taiwan. It has now gone down, make its way all the way down to Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia, definitely Thailand, and Japan.
It doesn't come cheap. Malt is never cheap. It's like very fine wine. It's distilled very, very carefully. And so you'll probably end up starting with a minimum of $100 to $150 for a bottle of malt whiskey. We are looking at the 25, which we have, the Tomatin 25, will be in the region of about $400. And if you're looking at the Tomatin 30, it will be like in the region of about $700. And if you're looking at the Tomatin 40, it's the region of $1,000.
It's not Scotch whiskey unless it's been in a cask, I think, for 3 years. That's one of the rules.
That's one of the rules, okay.
It's got to be made in Scotland.
Right.
It's got to be made with malted barley. I think that's about it. Malted barley made in Scotland, kept for 3 years in oak.
Is it a sort of guilty, not a guilty pleasure, but is it something you treat yourself to? You'll spend a bit of your monthly pay packet on a decent bottle, though. It's something you'll spend
on
money
on.
On more than one?
It's not an investment.
It's not an investment, but it could be, I suppose.
For some, but there are many fine art avenues to invest in. You could buy cars, paintings, watches, whatever.
But do you use whiskey on that kind of level?
For some people. For some kind of people who lay down wines and treat it as an investment, you could do that. These are the people who buy rare whiskies at auction.
I think there's about 100 active distilleries, maybe 110, and each of them produce different expressions, the 12, the 15, the 18, the 20 or 25 or whatever, and then they port wood or double cask, whatever they do. So you have about 10 expressions from each distillery, so that's 1,000 whiskies to explore. Once you start to wander through them, it becomes a journey because there's always a whiskey you haven't tried, and they're not all the same. They are similar, they echo each other, they refer to each other, but there's a broad spectrum from the Peaty Islas to the triple distilled Campbelltowns and everything in between. What you can look forward to is that if you see a new whiskey, if you see a new label, or a different expression from a label that you're familiar with, it'd be worth exploring, it'd be worth taking a sip and then thinking about it, thinking how it fits and where it goes.
And you'd be able to tell instantly, for instance, if you were trying the Tomatin 40 for the first time, you would know it was a relative of the 25 just by the taste.
I wouldn't, I'm not that good of a connoisseur, but I would recognize it as a Spey or a Highland, which is the region.
The river.
These are Spey sides, or North Highland, depending
coming
on
from
how,
Inverness,
they're,
yeah.
How they're classified. Mm. There's lowlands, Spey sides, highlands, islands, and islas, which is one island.
Can you tell us a little bit more before we finish about maybe some of the other whiskies that are being drunk here this evening?
There's half a dozen over there, and some. And I come back to this idea that everyone is slightly different. 100 years ago, around about exactly 100 years ago, appellation rules were set in European, British, North American countries to protect their local industries. So, for instance, the cognac industry had rules written by the French government that mandated what cognac was.
Like champagne must come from champagne.
Yes, champagne comes from champagne. Yeah. So the cognac rules were written grapes from, I think it's 5 or 15 regions in the cognac district, harvested at a particular time, particular types of grapes, distilled in a particular manner, cast off in French Limousin oak, and kept in cellars for a particular amount of time. In North America, the bourbon rules were written, and when the North American rules were written, I believe the Coopers Union, the barrel makers, was strong enough to get written into the legislation that it wasn't bourbon unless it was cast off in a brand new barrel of American white oak. In Scotland, they didn't have a government. The government was in Westminster.
Sure.
Now, the people in Westminster drink whiskey, but they're not that concerned about
local businesses and how they're maybe affected?
So they were kind of casual when they wrote the rules, and they said it's got to be made in Scotland, you've got to keep it in a cask of oak for 3 years, and it's got to be made with malted barley. And that was essentially the rules for Scotch malt whiskey.
I wouldn't be amazed if that wasn't tightened up sometime.
Well, it doesn't need to be, and that's why there are 1,000 different expressions of Scotch.
So it's a good thing?
It is. It means that it's variety. That means that all bourbons taste the same because they're in the tarry wooden white oak barrel. I mean, Jack Daniels and others do their best to char them with flames to make the charcoal and everything to soften them up. That's why there's not so many different types of cognac, because the rules are so tight. That's why Scotch is becoming so popular, because it's a rainbow, it's a spectrum. There is such a diversity, and yet it's all recognizable whiskey. You can taste the whiskey for the first time and wonder when it would be appropriate. Some will substitute for a sherry aperitif before a meal.
Right.
Some will substitute for a cognac after a meal. Mm. Some will fit the occasion when you're smoking a cigar. Some will work when you're in Scotland in the winter. It's snowing, it's dark outside, your feet are wet, you just tramped through 4 foot of snow for a mile, and you got into the house, the steam rising off your clothes, the fire's burning away, and there's a whiskey for that moment.
Okay.
Others work in the tropics. You're out in Singapore, you're in some bar outside, it's dark, it's hot, it's humid, there's a whiskey that fits that moment. So whenever you taste one, you've got to think about, when would I really enjoy this? And file that away and roll it back out when that occasion comes along and see if it is the perfect whiskey for that moment.